back to a new studio vlog. This morning I have some sticker orders that I need to mail out. And then I'm going to go to a Bible study this morning, and then after I'm going to a coffee shop to do some computer work and have some lunch. And then I'm going to come back home and then do some taxes. Yay, I cannot wait. Then tomorrow, I don't know what I have planned tomorrow. I think it's computer work again. I think. But I will be back soon and we will be painting together with some watercolor, so I'm really excited about that. And I'm planning on making some watercolor tutorials. So that's kind of a glimpse into this coming week. So I'm going to go now and I will see you soon. I just wasted like 2 hours of my day because I'm trying to put together a tutorial. So my goal today is to film 2 watercolor tutorials for YouTube. Trying to like branch out and try new things. So I thought that I would try out some like little watercolor doodles or like watercolor, like loose watercolor flowers. Like for spring, like spring flowers. I hope I'm making sense. Anyways, I drew out, you know, daffodils, and then I was thinking of these other 5 flowers and like doing some kind of like collage on a sheet of watercolor paper, like kind of like the herb drawing tutorial I did last year. So here I practice a little bit on the scrapped watercolor paper that I have, because on the back is this. And I'm just not feeling it. I'm not feeling like the pen outline or just loosely. And I'm not that great at loose flowers, if you can tell. Painting realistically or like semi-realistically is more my thing, and it's what I enjoy painting. I just need to learn from this. I've done this before. I've tried to do things that are kind of not me, like with watercolor or art. So I just need to learn from this. Anyways, so that's disappointing. I don't know if I'll be able to film two tutorials like I have planned. Let's try to film at least one today. What do you say? So I did some research and it seems like how to paint a watercolor rose would be a good option to do, because it seems like a lot of people search for that, and it's something that I would like to paint anyways, a rose. I feel like that would be really cool to paint. And also, Valentine's Day is coming up. I'm not really into Valentine's Day, but, you know, I guess it's kind of fitting, right? Yeah, let's try that and get that done. And then, depending on how much time we have left in the day, we can try out maybe another watercolor tutorial. Yeah, so let's do it. Painting for the tutorial. It's kind of different than my usual artwork, but it was really fun to play around with the background and with some abstract elements. I added some metallic paints to this painting to make it shimmer. The tutorial should be up before this vlog, so if you'd like to check it out, I will link it in the card above or in the description below. Well, I have one tutorial finished. There's about, I think, 3 hours left in the workday, and I am pretty tired. I'm just kind of tired of painting. I feel like I can only paint for, like, I don't know, 3 or 4 hours in a day, and then after that I just can't do it anymore. It just requires a lot of energy from me and concentration, at least that's what it is like for me. So now I think I'm going to make some tea and get a head start on this tutorial, like editing the tutorial. So tomorrow's plan is to edit this tutorial and get it up on YouTube. And that will probably take basically the whole day, if I'm being quite honest with myself. Okay, I will see you soon. Exercise because I've been literally sitting on my butt most of the week at my computer or my desk painting, so I really need to get some exercise today. And then this afternoon we will be painting, which I am so excited to paint. I can't wait. I'll see you soon. Thank you. you guys think of this painting? I think this one is my favorite so far out of the three that I've painted. And this is actually the first time I've painted crystals. And it was quite challenging. Yeah, this painting shimmers in the light in some areas. These shimmery paints are from Camas Watercolor on Etsy. Don't know if you can tell that well in this video, but in person, this painting is like really shimmery. I really want to show you these paints. They are just so pretty. Obviously, I use the purple and pink the most, and then this blue too. They're just so beautiful. And then here is the last bell jar that we'll paint. I'm thinking that I might try to paint this weekend, and I plan on vlogging during that so you can see the process. Hello there. I thought I would chat with you a little bit and do a voiceover. At the time of this voiceover, it's Monday, and I am in the process of editing this vlog. And I'm really excited to say that 2 days ago, on Saturday, we reached 1,000 YouTube subscribers. And I am just so thankful for that, and that I can help and serve 1,000 of you through my videos and share my art journey with you and share my, like, all of my knowledge that I have and everything I've been learning with my art business and with art. So I'm just so blessed to have all 1,000 of you here with me on this journey. So thank you for that. Thank you for helping me get to 1,000 subscribers. Yay! And on Instagram stories, I kind of shared a little bit that I don't put too much worth behind numbers. I feel like numbers should not determine our value or worth. So I just want to say that, but still, reaching 1,000 is a total blessing. And I started my YouTube channel February 2018, and now it's January 2020, and it's taken me 2 years to reach 1,000, and I've put in so much work with these videos and with learning how to edit and how to film better, and just trying to help and serve other artists and creatives and help inspire other people. And I'm just, it's just taken a lot of work, and I basically have been uploading almost one video a week for 2 years. I did take a like 5 month break in 2018, but other than that, I've been uploading every week. So it's just kind of rewarding to start seeing my channel grow and to reach more of you. So thank you for that. And I also want to mention that I am doing a card giveaway at the moment. So if you're interested in entering to win a set of all 10 of my greeting cards, I will link that link in the description of this video. And it ends on Thursday, so be sure to enter as soon as this vlog goes out, or like a day or two after this vlog goes out. And if you missed it, that's okay, because I'll be doing more giveaways. And speaking of cards, I am also having a card sale, because I want to retire all of my greeting cards to make room for new products. So I will link that link to my card sale in the description too, if you're interested. And I thought I would take this time to update you on my new free watercolor class. So if you've been following my journey for a while, you probably know that I have been creating some watercolor classes, and I just finished the first one, and it is free. It's all about watercolor supplies for beginners who want to learn watercolor, and it launched last Saturday. So about a week and a half ago, and I officially have 25 students enrolled in it. And I just want to say, if you did enroll, thank you so much. It's a blessing to help other people learn watercolor and to get them started and to just help them in any way I can, because watercolor is just amazing. So if you're one of those people, thank you so much. And if you're interested in enrolling, it's totally free. I will put the link in the description of this video. And here, as you can see, I am painting the fourth bell jar butterfly and moth collection. And I'm officially finished with it. Yay! We painted four of these and I'm just really happy with them. I was thinking of making these four bell jars into sticker sheets. So I'd love to know what you think about that, if that is something you're interested in. And these sticker sheets can be for like journals, planners, notebooks, really anything that you want to decorate with stickers. And these stickers would also be waterproof, so you could also put them on your water bottles and laptops and stuff. Let me know what you think about that idea, because I don't want to like put in the work to make these sticker sheets and order them if no one really wants them. So let me know what you think about that. And also, next week, in next week's vlog, we will be doing a market. So I have a market next week, and it is a gardening show, which is totally new to me. It's going to be different than my other market. So I'm really excited to see what this market will be like. And I'm excited to take you along with me. So stay tuned for next week's vlog. It'll be fun. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel or liked this video, please feel free to do so if you want to, no pressure. And just comment below, let me know your thoughts on the sticker sheets and anything else you'd like to tell me. I love to read your comments and talk to you guys, so yay. Anyways, I appreciate you, thank you for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye.